Hello student, today we are going to see what is force per unit length and also define ampere. Okay, so what define ampere, usually they will use as the force per unit length. Okay, that is the thing we are going to discuss. Okay, so first we should know what is a magnetic field is going to produce around the straight current carrying conductor, then only we can come to know what is define ampere. Okay, first we'll see what is a magnetic field is produced around the straight current carrying conductor. The current carrying conductor we have like this. Okay, the current is flowing upwards. So I am taken I current is flowing upwards. Then I used right hand thumb rule. The magnetic field is producing like this. So circular magnetic field is producing like this. So like this magnetic field is producing. So I am using Ampere circuit law to find what is a magnetic field is produced here. B is equal to question mark. Okay, I am going to use as the Ampere circuit law. What is Ampere circuit law? It says integration of B d l is equal to mu naught times of I. It is a closed integral. It's only applicable of closed surface. Okay, so I am taken here, it's a closed surface, is a circle. Okay, so it is a B. Okay, so it is, I am taken as a dl. Integration of dl, it's at the radius of r, or d also we can take it, at the radius of r. Okay, so this circle radius is r. I am taken here, you can take it here also. Okay, now B is equal to question mark. B is equal to, it's a integration of bdl is equal to mu naught times of I. So integration of bdl, it's a integral of dl, it's a l, that is here it is a 2 pi r is equal to mu naught times of I. Now what is B? What is a magnetic field is produced due to the straight wire current carrying conductor? B is equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi r. So we got what is a magnetic field is produced straight wire current carrying conductor. Okay, in this concept we have two wire. Okay, so two straight wire current carrying conductor. So both the current I am taken as the upwards. So I1 I2. So what is a magnetic field is produced for the first wire? Okay, right hand thumb rule, the current is upwards, the magnetic field will be like this. The magnetic field, so I have right hand thumb rule, the magnetic field will be this direction. At this point the magnetic field B1 is pointing like this. Okay, now due to the second wire, the current is upwards. Due to the second wire, the magnetic field is produced like this. So it's a right hand thumb rule, it is, current is upwards. Okay, the magnetic field is produced like this. Here B2 is created due to I2, B1 is created due to I1. Okay, so B2 is created on the first wire. Okay, and due to the second wire, so we got that is like this. Okay, it is I1 current, I1 wire. Okay, B2 magnetic field is produced. Here I2 wire, B1 magnetic field is produced. B1 is produced due to I1, B2 is produced due to I2. Okay, now we'll see, already we know straight wire current carrying conductor, what is a magnetic field? Magnetic field is equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi r, straight wire current carrying conductor. Here two straight wire is there, okay? So both is upwards. Due to I1, B1 is created. Due to I2, B2 is created, okay? Now B1 equation. B1 is equal to mu naught times of I1 divided by 2 pi r. R is the distance between the two circles. Now, what is a B2? B2 is equal to mu naught times of I2 divided by 2 pi r. Okay, so we know what is the magnetic field produced both the wire. Okay, B1 and B2. Now force, what is a force is created between the two wire. So I have two wires, both the current is flowing as upwards, wire 1, okay, and wire 2. So two wire I am taken, wire 1 and wire 2. So both the wire I am taken, wire 1, current to I1 is passing upwards. So due to I1, B1 is created here, okay, B1 is created here. So wire 2, I2 current is flowing, B2 current is flowing at this point, B2 current is flowing. So now force, how the force is created? We have to use it Fleming left hand rule, okay. So Fleming left hand rule, force, so you can write it, that is the best, okay. Force, F, B, magnetic field and the current, okay. First we'll see here, what is, which direction force is getting. So FBI will be upwards, okay, B will be outwards, so force will be created towards, okay, that means force in the wire is created towards. So F1 is created towards. F1 is created due towards, okay? And angle between B1 and B2, I1 is 90 degree, okay? The force is created in the third direction. So, F1 is created due to, B1 and I1. It is B2, I1 and length 1. It's a first wire length I am taken as L1, okay? Now, second wire, okay? Wire 2. The angle between the current and magnetic field is 90 degree, okay? Now, the same left-hand rule I am using, okay? FBI. B will be inwards, I will be upwards. In this case also, force will be towards I am getting. So, F2 is getting as a towards. F2 I am getting as a towards, okay? So, both the wires going to attract like this. F1 will be like this. F2 will be like this. Both the wires going to attract each other. Because both the current is upwards, magnetic field and the current is became as a perpendicular, force is going to create according to the Fleming left hand rule. Okay, so the force is created in the wire. So what is the force is created? F1 is created due to B2, I1. Okay, F2 is created due to I2, B1. Okay, the same equation I am going to take it here. Okay, so F1 is created due to B2, I1 and L1. Okay, as already we know, B2 is created due to I2. So, it is mu naught times of I2, I1, L1 divided by 2 pi r. So, it is the force 1. So, force 1 divided by length 1 is equal to mu naught I1, I2 divided by 2 pi r. Now, we'll have the second thing, that side, another side. Okay, so force in the second wire. Force in the second wire, it is going to create due to B1. And I2, okay, it's created due to B1 and I2. F2 is equal to, it is a B1, I2, it is a L1, okay? L2, okay? In second wire, magnetic field is produced as a bus. First, it's a mu naught I1, I2, L2 divided by 2 pi r. Because B1 is created due to I1, that is the reason we have in equation I1. So, F2 divided by L2 is equal to mu naught I1. I2 divided by 2 pi r. The same equation I got F1 divided by L1. So, force per unit length, I got this much, okay. Now, what is define ampere? So, define ampere, it is a force per unit length is equal to, it is both the equation, whether it's a first or second wire, mu naught, it is I1, I2 divided by 2 pi r. So, distance between the two wire, I am taken as 1 meter, the current is 1 ampere, okay. So, I1 1 ampere, I2 1 ampere, okay, this is as 1, okay. So, force per unit length is equal to mu naught is 2 pi into 10 power minus 7. 1 ampere divided by 2 pi into 1. So, this get cancelled. So, I'll get as, it is mu naught is 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Sorry, it is 2 pi, finally we'll get as 2 pi into 10 power minus 7 newton per meter. So, it is a force of attraction between the 2 wire, 4 pi into 10 power minus 7, okay? When the current, both the wire current is moving upwards, the force is going to attract. When the current is the opposite side, the force is going to ripple, okay? Now, in case in your exam, they ask define ampere. The force of attraction or repulsion between the two wires is 2 into 10 power minus 7 newton per meter, okay? So, we found what is the force of attraction and repulsion between the two wires. If you like my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.